According to HubSpot research, 74% of marketers say that they are using web forms for lead generation. And 50% of marketers say that web forms are their number one converting lead generation tool. Welcome, this is How to HubSpot. I'm Thomas. I spent a couple of weeks just playing around in HubSpot's form builder, and there are some pretty neat things that I'm excited to show you today. Forms are a tool that helps convert visitors into leads by gaining information. In this video, we'll break down when to use a form, how to create them, and later on in the form of a treat, cookies. And be sure to follow along with our free form builder we've linked in the description below. Let's get started. There are five common types of forms. First one, contact forms. People will use this to ask a question, voice a concern, or even explain a need for a refund. Next, lead generation form, converting visitors into leads. Imagine that. Next is an order form. Again, it's exactly how it sounds. It's where visitors go to place an order on your website. Registration forms. This is for when visitors are interested in signing up for your service. And lastly, survey forms. This is what you can use to learn more about your customer's experience. Let's say for this example, I own a coffee shop. Let's call it Tommy's Coffee. So we'll want to create a, you guessed it, lead generation form. Our favorite. All right, to get started, we're gonna navigate down to marketing and forms. In the upper right corner, you'll see an orange button, create form. We want the customers to land on this form when they visit our website, so we wanna make it an embedded form. And then we're gonna click next on the top right. And also we're gonna choose blank template for this. First things first, we want to add a header. The header is going to be the name of the form and what we are trying to offer. So if you go to create new and we go to header text, and slide that above the first field, we're going to call this Labor Day weekend sale 15% off. Let's center this and we are going to make this white. And I know for a second it's going to look bizarre, but it'll all make sense in a couple of moments. Next, we want to add rich text just below the header. And this gives the visitors just a bit more information of what the form is about and what they are receiving. We are going to insert subheader. So for this text, it's going to say, get 15% off any bag of coffee in September. I don't love this font. I'm going to change it to something a little more modern. That looks good. And we want to bold 15% off just so visitors are extra clear on what we are promoting. We're also going to center this and we are going to make it white as well. We are looking good right now. The beginning of the form is looking great. Now we need to add the three important fields that we want to collect from the visitors. Email is already there. We're going to add first name and last name, and those will go below the subheader. These are all the fields that we will need in our form. Now we'll go down to other form elements, and you'll see this button called CAPTCHA. It's always important to make sure that CAPTCHA is turned on because this will protect your form from spam and also keep it secure. We love safety. Next, we're going to go over to options, and this is where you can edit and create your thank you message. Of course, you always want to thank your visitors or your customers whenever they're filling out a form. So we're going to replace the template text with thank you for claiming your 15% off. We hope you enjoy your fresh brew on us. It just makes you feel appreciated. That's all. Now we scroll down to customizing your life cycle stage based on submissions. This is automatically set to default. We'll leave that as is. And then we want them to get a confirmation email when they fill out the form. So we want to check this box. And then you can also decide who in your team receives emails for when a customer fills out a form. And there you can choose your whole team or specific members of your team. Next, my favorite part personally is style. I wanna change what these properties look like. The boxes are kind of mundane and kind of boring. I wanna make this round. That looks great. Scroll down to style. We can kind of adjust how everything looks. So let's make this again, just a better looking font. I like this one. That looks great. We'll make this brown because it's on brand, coffee. Brown, that looks good. And let's make these a little bigger. The first name, last name, email is a little more prominent. That looks nice. And now for the critical part, the button. Button is orange. We're gonna change that to white and we're gonna change the text to brown and then align it to the center and bump it up just a bit in size so it is pretty noticeable. That looks great. Now our form is made, but it needs to be placed within a pop-up box on our website when visitors arrive. In order to do that, you have to click on HubSpot on the right-hand side here and click Go to CTAs. On the top right corner, click Create. And we want to start from scratch. And like I said, we want to do a pop-up box that's going to pop up on our main homepage. On the top, we'll name this Labor Day Weekend 2024. Before we add in our form, I want to change the background so it's not just a boring white box. If you click on the background, select the list, click Image, and then browse images. I like this one. Next, we are going to delete this image module because we added a background image, so that's not necessary. We'll take away this text and we'll take away this button. If you go over to add module, now we're going to add in our form. Drag and drop, click the form. From the list, you'll see Labor Day weekend 2024. Magic. The only thing is that each field is still the wrong color. So if you go to design, go to styles, here we can change the text to what we need it to be. We want this to be white, voila. Next, we want to go to targeting. If you scroll down, we want to make sure that this pop-up box does show up on the homepage. If you click under website URL, change that to is, and then here you will insert your homepage URL. We want to schedule this and make sure that it is in fact on Labor Day weekend and throughout the whole month of September. You can schedule for later. Start date, August 30th, we'll click on that, and we'll make it at 1 a.m. And you want to make sure that this does end at some point and it doesn't keep popping up on your website. So we'll set up an unpublished date and time, and we'll make this the last day of September, which is also the 30th. And that can be at 11:30 p.m. So we've made the form, brought it into a pop-up box, changed the style, added the targeting and the publishing dates. We are ready to rock and roll, and this baby can get published. It's time for the sweet stuff, cookies. Quick definition. They're small pieces of data to track a user's online activity for marketing and advertising purposes. So let's take a deeper look at how cookies work with HubSpot Forms. HubSpot Forms work naturally as we consider form submissions based on cookies. We'll drop a cookie in the visitor's browser as they submit a form. If they submit a form again, we'll look for that cookie before we look for the email address because we think most times the same customer will be submitting the same form on the same device. And if we've gotten a new email that we don't have in our system, we'll create a new contact instead of using the cookie to associate them. That being said, I recommend turning this on. If we go back to the options page and we scroll down to other submission settings, this is where you can enable this. Always create contact for new email address. This will create a new contact record based on if the email address is different, not the cookies. Therefore, form fields will not pre-populate with known information. You can find more information in the knowledge-based articles we've linked in the description below. That's the lead generation form. Like I mentioned before, you can create all types of forms on HubSpot. Let me know in the comments if you'd like more form tutorials. And that's a wrap, folks. Remember, while marketing trends may come and go, the right strategy makes all the difference. Keep experimenting, stay updated, and most importantly, keep those forms working for you. And don't forget, if you haven't already, check out our free online form builder. Click in the link in the description below to generate those leads. See you next time.